I'm Ilyan St. Hilaire, and in this video, we're going to talk about new account CAPTCHA. So one of the concerns with putting a MeshCentral server online is that you have the opportunity for robots to come into various bots and to try to perform operations over and over again on your server. And this has been a long-standing concern for many websites. And so, for example, a bot could try to create lots and lots of accounts or things like that. So you want to be able to stop that. And the way people stop that is by using CAPTCHA. So you may have seen this. I have a few slides here. You may have seen this on Google or on various websites. And CAPTCHA stands for Completely Automated Public Turing Testing to Tell Computers and Humans Apart. Apparently, I did not know this before researching it. And so what you want to do is anytime you have an operation that could be automated and could cause, you know, a bunch of issues like somebody coming to your server and creating 20,000 accounts or something, all bogus, of course. That's, you know, not super fun. So what you want to do is be able to detect that that's an actual human making the request and not a machine. So MeshCentral does have, in some cases, an opportunity for bots to do this, and this is when you create new accounts. Now, by default, you cannot create a new account on the login page, but you can turn that option on. And so then when you turn it on, you'll see on the login page, like username and password, it prompts you for that. And if you don't have one, you can create an account right there, and then you have your account prompts. Well, the problem is this could be automated. So MeshCentral, the new version, has a way to turn on CAPTCHA for account creation. So it's the same dialog box as before, except that now we have this weird thing and with a security check, and you have to type in the letters and numbers that are in the that are written there. And so this is an SVG, basically a vector graphic that is generated by MeshCentral and put on the web page here, and you have to type the letters. Now, by the way, MeshCentral is not using any third-party CAPTCHA tool. So we're not going to Google, we're not going to any third-party site. This is, you know, admittedly not as high quality as some of the other websites, but it is completely built into MeshCentral. So you're not making any third-party access, which is great. And even though it's you know, it could be defeated with AI and stuff like that, it does create a higher level barrier to creating nasty stuff on your website. So it's kind of nice. Now, another thing that people will note as well, I don't have a server that has, you know, publicly creatable accounts, so I don't really need this. But there is another feature that's interesting. It is possible for you to allow your web server to your MeshCentral instance to have people come in and create accounts if the email address finishes with a certain domain. So, for example, you want your university, and you want students in university or everybody that has, an email address of some type at someuniversity.com. You want them to be able to create an account on your server, but you don't want anybody else to be able to do that. So there's an option in the config.json to allow you to limit account creation to specific domain email domains, but you may want to still turn on the CAPTCHA just so that some robot doesn't try to do this over and over again. Okay, so let's demo this for real. I'm going to use, of course, my nice trusty server right here. So just regular server. And right now it's configured in the config.json. It's configured with the default. So I have new accounts turned off. And so this is in the domain section of the config.json. So new accounts by default is off. So I have an underscore here, and the CAPTCHA is off. And this new account email domains, I won't set it, but I do want to show it off because that's an option that a lot of people don't know about. That's pretty cool. And by the way, there's another option also, new account user groups, which auto joins anybody who creates a new account to a user group. So if you want to have a user group for everybody that creates a new account through the login page, you can do that there. There's another option I don't have here called a new account password, where you basically have a string that you configure, and only people who know that string can create accounts. So that's another option you have. So once you configure, so by default, none of these are on. And so by default, the login page looks like this. So you have the Mesh Central, you have the username, you have the password, and that's it. There's a login button and the terms of privacy, and that's it. So nothing else. You can't create, if you don't have an account here, you can't do anything more. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to uncomment the new accounts line here and run Mesh Central again. And now if I hit refresh, it's going to say username, password, don't have an account, create one, click here. And so I can click here, type my username, email, password twice, and click create account. And if you have a SMTP or an email server hooked up to Mesh Central, then Mesh Central will send an email asking, verifying that the email account is correct. And if it is, then you'll be able to use the account correctly. Otherwise, you won't be able to use your account. So that's the barrier there. But, somebody could try to automate this. So what you do is you say new account CAPTCHA true. I'm going to restart the server again. And you hit refresh, you get the login page. I don't have an account. I'm going to click on create, and you will see the CAPTCHA right here. And so I'm just going to create an account for fun. I'm going to call it test@test.com. Here I don't have I do not have a SMTP server, active right now. So Mesh Central is not going to try this, but I'm just going to put test. And by the way, I didn't put any password requirements, but there's plenty of setup here in the config.json make it so that you have certain requirements on your password, minimum and maximum length, how many uppercase, lowercase, non-alphanumeric, and numeric. And you can set what your policy is. So here for my test here, I don't have any policies, but that's kind of important to have one. And then the security check, hopefully I'm human enough to do this. And I say create account. And actually there's an existing account with that email address. So that's good. By the way, I didn't plan on this to happen, but this is an interesting point I want to make, is that if there is a existing account, you will only know if after you answered the CAPTCHA correctly. So the CAPTCHA test is checked first before any other error messages. So this is interesting because you could have a bot trying to figure out which account exists on your server by creating accounts to see which one are available and which one are not. But that would dwarf this because you don't get this information until after the CAPTCHA is done. Okay, so anyway, that's good. And just to recap, or just to highlight two other settings here, there is one, I don't have it here, but there is a new account password. You can basically add a creation token. And so the nice thing is you can have your server, you can have it wide open, put a CAPTCHA like this, but also have a creation token. And then when you have a friend somewhere on the street and you're like, hey, you can create yourself an account on my server if you want. Here's the DNS name, here's the creation token. And then they can do that. So that's really nice. And the nice thing about the creation token that CAPTCHA is that it will be checked even before the creation token. So if somebody's trying to brute force the creation token or the password to create, they would also have to have CAPTCHA first, working first before they do that. And then the new account email domains, here you can say, for example, sample.com. That means that only users at sample.com, you know, would be allowed to create accounts on your server. So that's another, you know, fun restriction. Anyway, hopefully that was useful. A very quick video on new account creation on the login page using CAPTCHA. Thank you very much.